Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. In this video I will discuss about Guillain-Barré syndrome, that is GBS. Guillain-Barré syndrome was first described in 1859 by French physician Jean Alexander Barré and Edouard Guillain, who were the first to identify and document the condition. They observed a set of symptoms that included acute muscle weakness and paralysis in a group of patients. The syndrome was later named after both of them, Guillain and Barré, in recognition of their contribution to its discovery. Barré and Guillain, along with their colleague Andre Scholl, published their findings, which were instrumental in advancing the understanding of the syndrome. Guillain-Barré syndrome is a rare neurological disorder where the body's immune system mistakenly attacks the peripheral nervous system, which consists of the nerves outside the brain and spinal cord. The condition typically begins with muscle weakness or tingling sensation after starting in the legs and progressing upwards. GBS is thought to be triggered by an infection such as a viral or bacterial illness, for example, the flu, COVID-19, or Campylobacter infection. The body's immune system responds to the infection by attacking the peripheral nerves, mistakenly targeting them as if they were foreign invaders. Symptoms of GBS are weakness and tingling, that is paresthesia, fatigue, facial weakness, facial muscles may be affected, leading to difficulty with facial expressions such as smiling, difficulty swallowing or speaking, difficulty in breathing, fluctuating blood pressure, irregular heart rhythm, difficulty controlling body temperature, sweating abnormalities, digestive issues such as constipation or urinary retention, loss of reflexes, and progressive paralysis. In severe form, GBS can cause complete paralysis, including the respiratory muscles. While GBS can be life-threatening, many people do recover over time, although the recovery process can be slow, sometimes taking months or even years. Some people experience long-term effects such as weakness or numbness. GBS is considered a rare condition, but its exact prevalence can vary based on geographic region and population. On average, the incidence of GBS is estimated to be around 1 to 2 cases per 1 lakh people per year worldwide. GBS can affect people of any age, but it is more common in adults and males. The incidence tends to increase with age, particularly in those over 50. The prevalence of GBS can vary across different countries or regions. For example, some studies suggest a higher incidence in regions with certain infections, for example, tropical areas or places with high rates of infections like Campylobacter. Diagnosis of GBS involves a combination of clinical evaluation, medical history, and a specific diagnostic test to rule out other conditions and confirm the presence of GBS. Since GBS shares symptoms with other neurological disorders, early and accurate diagnosis is crucial for appropriate treatment. Electromyography, that is EMG, nerve conduction studies, that is NCS, and lumbar puncture are primarily valuable for confirming the diagnosis. The primary treatment for GBS are plasmapheresis and intravenous immunoglobulin, both of which aim to reduce the immune system's attack on peripheral nerves and speed recovery. Plasmapheresis is a procedure that involves removing the plasma from the patient's body blood and replacing it with a replacement fluid, usually albumin or a donor's plasma. The idea behind this treatment is to remove harmful antibodies or immune factors that may be attacking the nerve. This is typically done over a series of treatments, usually 5 sessions, over the course of about 1 to 2 weeks. That plasmapheresis can help reduce the severity of disease and may speed up the recovery process, especially if it started early, within the first 2 weeks of symptoms. Immunoglobulin therapy involves administration of immunoglobulin from healthy donors through an intravenous infusion. The goal of this treatment is to modulate the immune system, reducing its attack on the nerve while allowing the immune system to function normally. Like plasmapheresis, immunoglobulin has been shown to help reduce the severity of GBS and speedy recovery, especially if started early. It is typically given over the course of 5 days and is often preferred over plasmapheresis in some cases, particularly if plasmapheresis is not available. Supportive care, including respiratory support, pain management, and physical therapy, are crucial during both the acute and recovery phases of the illness. This is all about Guillain-Barré syndrome. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family members to spread awareness. If you have any question or personal experience or stories with this disease, drop a comment. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you. Thank you very much.